as a child, creating drawings, paintings, and playing with clay straight from the ground during recess was the thing that brought me the most joy in life. When I was creating and playing with mud, it was like nothing else in the world mattered. Nothing could upset me. As my imagination ran wild, I imagined my drawings and little clay figures coming to life, and it would bring me such joy. In Sunday school, I learned a valuable lesson from Isaiah 64:8, that we are the clay and God the Father is our potter, and we are all works of His hands. It wasn't until college that I learned to really work with clay and create functional pottery pieces. Even then, I don't think I completely grasped the lesson that God was trying to teach me. I was learning how to make pottery, and I wanted to be good and impress my teachers. In Exodus 31, God is talking to Moses about an artist that will be working to construct the tabernacle. He says, "I have filled him with the Spirit of God in wisdom, in understanding, in knowledge, and in all manner of workmanship to design artistic works, to work in gold, in silver, in bronze, in cutting jewels, for setting, in carving wood, to work in all manner of workmanship. I have put wisdom in the hearts of all the gifted artisans, that they may make all that I have commanded." Recently, God spoke to my heart as I worked alone in my classroom building a vase. I felt overwhelmed by God telling me that He has given me this gift Himself, and He wants me to use it to bring Him glory. I had tears in my eyes, and my heart was beating fast. But I said, "Yes, Lord, please give me the talent of working with clay, of teaching children, and use me as a vessel for Your glory." As a clay artist, I want soft, fresh clay to work with so I can create functional pieces. God wants my heart to be soft towards His Word so He can mold me and create a useful and beautiful vessel for Him. After all, He has molded me and created me in His own image. My name is Carolina Galvi Balma, and this is my act of worship.
The Bible tells us every good and perfect gift is from above. Language is one of those gifts. God gave us the gift of language so that we could communicate with each other. For most of us, communication is simply speaking and listening, but for some, there are great obstacles to overcome. When the sense of hearing is not present, communication becomes very difficult. The deaf have to learn an entirely different way of communicating with those around them. I became fascinated with sign language when I was 10 years old. I met a lady at church who was blind and deaf. Every Sunday, I would say hello to her, and she would teach me a new sign. After graduating from PCA in 2003, I went to Baylor and started studying sign language more seriously. I eventually became proficient in American Sign Language, and I am now involved in the deaf ministry at Prestonwood. Sign language is a beautiful way of displaying the meaning of words with your hands. I love worshiping in sign language as it is a way of expressing to the Lord what the lyrics mean to me. My name is Micah Reese, and this is my act of worship.
All my words fall short, I got nothing new. How could I express all my gratitude? I could sing these songs as I often do, but every song must end, and you never do. So I throw up my hands and praise you again and again, 'cause all that I have is a hallelujah, for a king, except for a heart singing hallelujah, hallelujah. I've got one response.
Johann Sebastian Bach was born into a musical family and quickly mastered the organ, harpsichord, and violin. In his teens, Bach began to compose music, and his life's work is recognized as some of the most brilliant pieces of music ever written. It has been said of Bach, besides being one of the most productive musical geniuses ever, Bach was also a theologian who just happened to work with a keyboard. During his lifetime, Bach was completely committed to utilizing his gifts as acts of worship before the Lord and maintained that all works should be used for the glory of God. It is easy to see this demonstrated by noting his signature sign-off at the end of his compositions, the initials SDG, Soli Deo Gloria, to God alone be the glory. In his own words, J.S. Bach said, "The aim and final end of all music should be none other than the glory of God and the refreshment of the soul." My name is Everly Roach, and this is my act of worship.
Fighting voices in my mind that say I'm not enough. Every single lie that tells me I will never measure up. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low? Remind me once again just who I am, because I need to know.
Oh, you say I'm yours,
giving all I have, and now I'm laying it at your feet. You'll have every failure, God. You'll have every victory.
Ooh, oh. You say I love, but I can't.